first thing you do for a brake job is get out your wheel key and your plastic removal lock if you need it. So we got the wheel key. I don't need this, but this is where you'll find it. Stashed in that little hole. I got my own tool, which I'll show you later. Next thing is you're going to remove your plastic covers off your lugs. I use a basic hook tool. Do be careful that you don't scratch stuff. If you slip, it's real easy, like that. You got to just take your time, don't rush. If some of them are stuck harder, you'll slip and you'll scratch your rim right up. So you kind of look for some place you can get it under it. The VW hook tool might work better, I don't know. But I'm just careful with it. Then you expose your lugs. Just for a test and my own learning experience, I'm going to try the VW tool instead. Your finger, in, hook. Alright, I give in. The VW tool is a lot better than my hook, so I guess I'll be using this tool from now on. Much easier. Use the tool. Don't forget to crack your lugs loose before you lift the car. You've got a 17-inch socket, basic breaker bar. This chassis is so stiff that the rear tire comes off the ground too. Totally stock suspension. Again, the purpose of this video, I'm going to apply some anti-seize lube on the back of these pads. I've had a few sets of Hawk pads, and this is the first time ever they were squealing today. Of course, it was my car told me the outside temp was 95 to 98 degrees. So it was a super hot day. Obviously, that's why it happened. But I didn't put any squeak on these yet. I'm going to go ahead and try that just to give another test for the rest of the week and see if I can solve this squeaking with a little bit of lube. I'm going to start with peeling off the protective cap off your sliders. Don't lose the cap. You're then going to take what I believe is a 7mm Allen and you're going to break loose your bolts. Always do one side at a time in case you forget how things go. I'm going to remove the bracket. I'll go under it and pop it right off. You just got to remember how it goes, and you're not going to forget if you do the other side. There are holes in those divots too, which these plug into. You're then going to simply remove your caliper. Carefully. Like those cutoffs. White trash. This wire is a little tight. I forgot to do that. Hold on. So you push down here, just like the other harnesses in your engine compartment. You slide off your thing. It's a little tight fit here, but it's fine. That was my mistake. So undo your ABS sensor before you pull the caliper off. You should usually hang it. If you're careful, you can set it somewhere. Be real careful. If you're safe, you'll hang it with a bungee or something like that. For a short period of time, I just leave it on top here. There's movement. It's not like it's super stretched or bent or anything. So I'll just be careful when I do mine here. This pad is going to pop out. and you have this here. You might notice that I just broke my pad. I just broke the sensor. So that's bad luck on my part, but I'm still going to do the job for you. I'm actually just learning something about this sensor. There is no wires here that broke. This simply pushes in there. I'm going to go ahead and just push it back in, and we should be all right. There is no broke wires. It somehow just senses in the bottom there. So I'll cinch that back in when I'm done, and it might be all right. You're first going to take some lube and go around your piston circle. Do not do the whole entire pad. There's no reason to. There's only specific spots that make contact. That's all you need to do. So I'm doing the piston circle. There's markings there so you know where it touches. This may be pretty basic stuff to almost everybody that watches these videos, but there's always that one person that might want to know about this. When you slide it on this other side, you're just putting it in the top area, not the bottom. You don't really need to, a little bit maybe. When you push the caliper on, it's going to force the liquid there. You don't want too much. So I'm going at the top here, where the caliper forks come on. Then they push down here. Just put a real thin coat because you don't really need any at the bottom. It's just going to naturally spread. Make sure I got it at the top. That's all there is to the gel. You definitely don't overdo it. When you're putting it back on, your sensor just comes through the middle here. Make sure it doesn't get caught. And it's just going to snap in afterwards. I'll be careful with that since it's broken. Slide this on. If it won't slide in, your pins are in too far, you can move your pins out till it seats all the way down. That's just about seated the whole way. You're just going to keep working your bolts until they start and then snug those up. Don't kill yourself on these. You can strip them. You gotta use your common sense. This is about as tight as I can do it, but it's a small ratchet, so it's not gonna overdo it. Don't forget to put your caps over your Allens. Keep the dirt out. Easy to get them out next time. Then you're gonna have your clip. Figure out how it goes. And here, start with the bottom is fine. And you can start with the top in and stretch out the top. So bottom, one side's easy, then do your pin and then stretch this tab over, pop it in, a couple bangs, the clip seated, all done. Before you put your car back down, just snug up your bolts a little bit. You can use the crisscross side pattern. Short little ratchet just to make sure everything's seated nice. Makes it easier to torque later. Final step is your torque. You can look up the official VW specs if you want, or just kind of go by experience. I just do a 90 on these. Probably 85-90 is good. These ain't huge truck tires. And the torque wrench, you stop when you click. Super cool. Crisscross pattern, never in a circle. Furthest one away from you is always your next bolt. That's all torque. I'm super anal. I'll do them all twice to make sure. Done. Put your caps back on. Check all five, and the brake job's done.